पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्याम् मामा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु। तदात्मनि निरते योपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्ति। श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः। ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐमित्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ओमिते ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम्। तदनन्यत्वम् आरम्भण शब्दादिभ्यः तत् अनन्यत्वम्। दैट जगत ऑल यूनिवर्स इज नॉट सेपरेट फ्रॉम ब्रह्मन्। दैट इज द अनन्यता। अंडरस्टैंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन अभेद सो अभिन्नता एंड अनन्यता आर डिफरेंट थिंग्स। एज भाष्यकर एक्सप्लेन्स अनन्यम अनन्यत्वम् व्यतिरेकेण अभावः। Meaning that effect cannot exist separate from the material cause. Arambhana shabdadibhya. This is what we learn from the illustrations of Upanishads involving the Arambhana shabda. Arambhana means that it has origin. So from these words such as origin, this is what we learn. अभ्युपगम्य च इमं व्यावहारिकं भोक्तृभोग्यलक्षण विभागं स्याद् लोकोदिति परिहारो विहितः। द प्रीवियस सूत्र एंड आल्सो प्रीवियस अधिकरणम् द परिहार द रेफ्यूटेशन वाज गिवन। द डाउट वाज क्वेश्चन वाज डेल्ट विथ। अभ्युपगम्य फॉर द सेक ऑफ आर्ग्यूमेंट वी एक्सेप्टेड that this vibhaga, the distinction between the bhogya and the bhokta, the distinction between the experienced and the experiencer, can very well be there even when the material cause Brahman is one or non-dual. It is explained by the illustration of the ocean and the waves and the bubbles and the foam. How even though the ocean is one, still it is not in any way come in conflict with the manyness of the waves and the foam and the bubble and the interaction that takes place between them. All of this is not in any way affected by the oneness of ocean. Similarly, the oneness of Brahman would not affect the manyness of the world involving this division such as the Bhogya and the Bhokta. This was a parihara. This was an answer or refutation given, accepting for the time being, for the sake of argument, we accepted the oneness of the cause and manyness of the effect. Nadu ayam vibhaga paramartha asti. Not that this vibhaga, this distinction between the object and the subject, that vibhaga is not paramarthataha, or between the various members of the effect, such as pots and pans, that they are essential difference. There is no essential difference among them. Similarly also, there is no paramarthika. There is no essential difference between the bhogya and the bhokta. Yasmat tayoho karyakaranayoho ananyatvam abhyupagamyate. So as Bhashya Ratna Prabha said, pratyakshadinam autsargika pramanyam angikritya. Accepting for the sake of argument, that perception also is a pramanam. What you perceive also is valid. Meaning that the pratyaksha, our sense organs, our perception, reveals a division between the object and the subject. The angikrita, angikritya, accepting that difference that we perceive, sura buddhi samadhanartham parinama drishtantena. Sthura buddhi samadhanartham, for the person who is not able to see the subtlety, can see only the what is on the surface. So one who draws conclusions based on what is perceptible superficially, and the person who is not able to see through the perception and appreciate the reality. So, sthula buddhi means sukshma buddhi rahityam. For a person who does not enjoy the subtlety of the intellect, which can see the essentiality, which is only the superficiality. Parinama drishtantena bheda bheda uktau. That we accepted for the sake of argument that bheda and abheda are all right. Abheda at the level of the material cause and bheda at the level of the effect was accepted. Samprati angikrutam pramanyam tattva vedakatva prachyavya. Now we say that this pramanyam, the authenticity, the validity of the perception is all right, but not as far as tattva or the reality is concerned. The perception has its scope as far as the vyavahara or the empirical reality is concerned, but perception does not have scope with reference to paramartha or the absolute reality. Vyavaharikatve sthapyate. So perception also is valid, where it has a scope, namely vyavahara, namely the empirical reality. Tathaca mithyadvaitagrahi pramanehi advaitashrutehe nabadaha. There were the means of knowledge, such as perception and others, which are mithyadvaitagrahi, which have a scope with reference to the valid knowledge with reference to perception of the duality, which is mithya. So perception and all the means of knowledge based on perception have a scope only with reference to empirical reality, which is mithya. And therefore, what we perceive at the level of empirical reality does not contradict what the Shruti says, because the scope is different. The perception and other means of knowledge have the scope only in the empirical reality, whereas the Shruti talks about the absolute reality. Therefore, this cannot contradict that. Ekasyam rajvam dandas sragadi dvaidarshanat idyam mukhya pariharah iti bhavah. Ekasyam rajvam, Raju is one. And what is the manyness? Then the danda sragadi dvairdarshanat. Somebody may pursue the rope as a danda, as a stick. Somebody may perceive the rope as a garland. So that duality is mithya. So formally the duality of the jagat was accepted as a duality between the waves and foam as real. But now the duality is mithya. So formally the parihara, the refutation was given, accepting the reality of this universe. Now the mukhya parihara, the primary refutation is given, where the universe is only taken as mithya and not real. And mithya cannot in any way oppose what is real. Evam advaita samanvayasya avirodartham dvaitasya mithyatam sadhayate. So advaita non-duality can be true only if the duality is mithya, not otherwise. Therefore, the samanvaya, the purport of the Upanishad, which is in a reality which is one and non-dual, now that samanvaya is not contradicted by the duality that we perceive at the empirical level, because this duality is mithya. So mithyatvam sadhayati, for that we have to establish mithyatvam, the unreality of the empirical world. So Bhashyakara said, yasmat tayoho karya karaneho ananyatvam avagamyate. Not abhinnatvam, ananyatvam. Therefore, what is the relationship between the karya and karana, the effect and material cause? Ananyatvam, non-separatedness. Karyam akashadikam. So karya vipratipattinasartham vishinasti. What do you mean by karyam? Karyam akashadikam bahuprapancham jagat. So karya karanayoho ananyatvam avagamyate. We accept the non-separatedness of the effect from the cause. What do you mean by the effect? So about effect also there should be no dispute. So Vasikara clarifies, kāyam ākāśājikam bahuprapancham jagat. The kāya, the effect, in this instance is this jagat, the universe, bahuprapancham, having its variety or multiplicity. Kāraṇam param brahma. So by kāraṇam we mean param brahma, which is presented by the Upanishad as the material cause of the universe. Tasmat karanat paramatada ananyatvam. So tat ananyatvam is what? Tasmat ananyatvam. Tasmat karanat paramatada ananyatvam. Meaning, what is ananyatvam? Vyatirekena abhavah. So karyakaranayoho ananyatvam iti ukte mithah ananyatvam saṅkitam vyāvartayati. When we say that there is non-separatedness between cause and effect, we do not mean that both of them enjoy the same degree of reality. That effect is non-separate from cause and cause is non-separate from effect. So that is the mitho ananyatvam. It's not the mutual non-separateness. It's one way only. नु कार्यप्रपञ्चस्य भेदाभेदाभ्याम् अनिर्वाच्यतामिच्छन् कारणात् परमात्तः अनन्यत्वं व्याचक्षणः सोक्त विरोधं कथं नाधिगच्छति. सो देन सो फार यू एक्सेप्टेड भेदाभेद कार्यप्रपञ्चस्य भेदाभेद भेदाभेदाभ्याम् अनिर्वाच्यतामिच्छन् कारणात् परमात्तः अनन्यत्वं व्याचक्षणः सोक्त विरोधं कथं न गच्छति. आई यू नॉट कॉन्ट्रडिक्टिंग बाय सेइंग दैट तद् अनन्यत्वं दैट बोथ ऑफ देम नॉन सेपरेट फ्रॉम ईच अदर. सो आई यू नॉट ऑन वन हैंड यू से दैट द जगत इज मिथ्या, ऑन द अदर हैंड यू से दैट दे आर नॉन सेपरेट, देयर व्यतिरेकेण अभावः. Bhashyakara says, ananyatva means vyatirekena abhavaha. Abhavaha, non-existence in isolation of the cause. The effect does not exist as separate from the cause. Kāyasya avagamyate, Vedanta accepts that the effect does not stand, does not exist apart from the material cause. Karyasya karana atirekena abhave hetum pruchyati. Yasmat eva avagamyate tasmat paramartha vibhago nasti. Since this is what we accept, there were the vibhaga, the division, apparent division between the object and subject is not the absolute division, is not the real division. In reality, the object is not separate from subject, or subject is not separate from object, meaning that they are not two independent entities. Like we said last time, if we inquire into what is the object, the bhogya, idasti bhati priyam. What is subject? The bhokta. Asti bhati priyam. So even the forms are different, shapes are different, but the truth is not different. The perception and other means of knowledge only reveal the forms. They do not reveal the truth. They reveal the forms. And there were conclusions arrived at by those pramana, the means of knowledge, does not contradict what the Upanishad reveals, which talks about the absolute reality. Therefore, hetum pruchyati. Why do you say? So, kutaha. The question is asked, on what basis do you say that vyatirekena bhava? Answer is given, Aramana Shabda Adibhyah. Aramana Shabda. So, Bhashyakara will explain. But Aramana Shabda Adibhyah comes from a sutra, from passages which talk about the Aramanam, origin. Bhuvatsita Hetu Vishayam Sutra Bhagam Avatarayati. So, Aramana Shabdadibhya is the Hetu. So, Hetu Vishayam Sutra Bhagam. We want to understand what do you mean by Aramana Shabdadibhya Bhuvatsitam. So, that is the desire to be known. What is the meaning of Aramana Shabdadibhya in the sutra? Please tell us. So, then Bhashyakara explains that. Let us read now, page 373, third line. This part we have read, but we are just reading again. Aramana shabdastavata eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam pratijnaya drishtanta apekshaya mucchate yatha somya ekena mrutpindena sarvam brahmam vijnatam syat vacharambhanam vikaro namadheyam mrutikaityeva satyam iti. This word arambhana, where does it appear? Arambhana shabdadibhyah. This word arambhana and similar words. So where does this word arambhana appear? Arambhana shabdastavada eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam pratijnaya. In the 6th chapter of the Chandogya Upanishad, pratijnaya, having proposed eka vijnanena sarva vijnanam yena ashrutam shrutam bhavati amatam matam avijnatam vijnatam iti. So that by hearing which everything is as well heard, that by thinking about which everything is as well thought of, that by knowing which everything is as well known, pratijnaya. So when pratijna is presented, parvato vandiman, that there is fire in that parvata, in that hillock. Then drushtanta apekshayam, hetu apekshayam, and drushtanta is given so that we can derive the hetu. Yatra yatra dhumaha tatra tatra vannihi. So dhumatva yatha mahanase. So you say that parvato vannima, that hillock has fire. Why do you say that? Dhumatvat, because there is smoke. So what? Yatra yatra dhuma tatra tatra vanni, because wherever the smoke is, that is where the fire must be. Where do you see that? Yatha mahanase, as we see in our kitchen and many other places. So when you present pratijna, automatically there is an expectancy of the hetu, of the reason. And for that expectancy of drishtanta. So dhumatvad is a hetu. But on what basis do you say that? Drishtanta must be yatha mahanase, just as in the kitchen. So drishtanta apekshayam uchyate. When the Shruti made the proposition of knowing one thing by knowing everything by knowledge of one, that is apeksha or expectancy of drishtanta illustration. And therefore the illustration was given, yatha somya ekena mrutpindena saram mrunmayam vijnatam syat. He somya, just by knowing one clod of earth, everything made of earth is as well known. Why is it so? Vacharambhanam vikaro namadhyam. What's called vikara or modification is vacharambhanam. It is only speech as the arambhanam origin. So what is called vikara? So spot etc. has its origin only in the speech. It exists only in name, namadhyam. It exists only in name. Vacharambhanam has its origin only in the speech. Mrityaka ityeva satyam. In that illustration, mrityaka, the clay alone is real. Meaning the iti means what? The material cause is real. Says Jnayanena, ghatadi vishayatvad esha shabda jagat vishayo na bhavati. Arambhana shabdadi arambhana shabda vacharambhanam vikaro namdhem mrityakayetiva satyam. So arambhana shabda does not refer to jagat, it refers to pots and pans. The example given in Chandogya Upanishad, The first vikara, modification, such as ghata, such as a pot. Therefore, each shabda jagat vishayo na bhavati. That arambana does not apply to jagat, applies to only parts. Tat katham jagato mithyatam tena siddhyati. So by that arambana shabda, which gives mithyatma of a part, how do you arrive at the mithyatma of the jagat? That illustration gives only mithyatma of pots and pans. How do you arrive at the mithyatma of the jagat? Idi ashankya jagat hai mithyatva sadhanatham adhidhishtana nivishtam vacharambhanam. Jagat hai mithyatva sadhanatham. Understand that the dushtanda is given by the Upanishad for clarifying or arriving at the mithyatvam, the unreality of jagat. Where adi dushtanda nivishtam, three dushtandas are given. First is what? Mrityaka etyav satyam, and then lohamani, etc. You know, so these different examples are given. Ekena lohamanina. So, of them the first example is of the clay and the pot. So, Bhashyakara gives this one, does not give second and third examples, you know. Nakhanikuntanam, Lohamani, etc. So, Bhashyakara gives only first example. So, Adhidushtanda. So, Adhidushtanda nivishtam, Vacharamadam, Darshtandikevi, Samarthyam Asteyam Samyatham Asteyam. The mithyatvam that applies to a part also applies to jagat, because there is a similarity between the dushtanta and darshtanta. So, because Chandogya Upanishad did not say Brahma ityeva satyam, if Chandogya said Mrityu ityeva satyam, that's where it stopped. Dushtanta was given, but the conclusion was not given. Tasmat jagat eva jagat mithya brahma satyam. If this was stated clearly, then this sutra would not have been necessary. But that they did not say. They only gave the example of clay and pot, etc., and did not extend that illustration to the darshtanta, to what is illustrated. So we have to do that here. So Bhashyakara says, etaduktam bhavate. So this is what the drishtanta or illustration means. Ekena mrutpindena paramarthatah mridatmana vijnatena sarvam mrunmayam ghatasharava udanchanadikam mridatmakatva avisheshat vijnatam bhavet yatah vacharambhanam vikaro namadheyam vacha eva kevalam asti iti arabhyate. Yad duktam bhavati, this is what we would understand from that example. Ekena mrutpindena paramarthatah mridatmana vijnatena. Ekena mrutpindena. So first we should add vijnatena. And paramarthatah vijnatena. Because a mrutpinda has to be understood properly. Mrutpinda is a lump of clay or some clod of earth, whatever, some form it has. The clay always presents itself in one or the other form. So what is meant by knowing mrutpinda? So says here, so paramatah vijnatena. When you know it in essence, what? Mrutsu mrudatmana vijnatena. When you see this fact that what is called mrutpinda or a clod of earth is nothing but clay. Because that is also a vikara, really speaking. So paramatah vijnatena. Mrudatmana vijnatena. Sara mrunmayam. Whatever then is made of mrut or the clay. Gata sharava udanchanadikam. Gata means a pot, sharava means a plate, udanchana means a jar, etc. Mrudatmakatva avisheshat vijnatam bhavet. So first of all, we should understand the drishtanta. How do you say that by knowing the clay, that the pots and all other vessels made of clay, that they become known? How? I see a pot, a clod of earth. How do I know a pot and a plate and a jar? How do I know? Vashyakara says, therefore, so paramatada mridatmana vijnatena. When you know this clod of earth, in reality as to what it is, which is clay, then sarumrunmayam, whatever is the modification of clay, such as a pot, a plate, a jar, mrudatmakatva avisheshat, there also have mrut or clay as an atma. Clay is the essence of the pots and the jars, etc. Therefore, in essentiality, they become known. By knowing the clod of earth as clay, whatever is made of clay is essentially known. Because for everything, there are two aspects. One is essential, other is incidental. So in clay also, there is the essential aspect, which is clay. There is the incidental aspect, which is its form and shape and usage. All of these are incidental aspect. So by knowing the essence, which is clay, you know this part only in essence, not as far as the incidental aspects are concerned. Katham anyasmin vijnate anyad vijnatam syadidi. By knowing that clod of earth, how do you say you know the pot? Knowing one thing, how do you know the other thing? So Vashyakara says, yataha vacharambhanam vikaro namadheyam. Because whatever is vikara, what is modification is vacharambhanam. Has its origin only in speech. So what is vacharana? Vacha eva kevalam asti iti arabhyate. What is vacharambhanam? Vacha arabhyate is vacharambhanam. Vacha is the third case of the word vag. That which is originated by speech. Kevalam asti iti arabhyate, that the pot is. This is how the speech, in fact, is the origin of the concept of pot is. So when you say pot is, that is merely the existence of the pot originates from speech. Pot is called is only by the speech, because there is no entity such as pot apart from clay. What is clay. And since the pot is, who says pot is? Only speech says that. So isness, I mean potness, only belongs to speech. Isness belongs to clay, the potness belongs to speech. Then Bhashyakara said, Vikar hai, ghat hai, sharav hai, udanchanam chaiti, nato vastu vrittena, vikaro nama kashit asti, namadhe matram hi, etat anrutam mrittika, ityeva satyamiti. So vikara, now what is vikara? Bhashyakara explains, because Upanishad doesn't say what is meant by vikara. Vacharambaram vikara namadhyam. What do you mean by vikara? So Bhashyakara says, vikara hai, ghata hai, sharava hai, udanchanam chaiti. So what the Shruti means by the word vikara is a pot, a plate, a jar, etc. Natu vastu vrittena vikaro nama kashchit asti. What does that vakya mean? That vakya means that vastu vrittena, in essence, in reality, vastu vikaro nama kashchit asti. In reality, there is no such thing as a pot or a plate or a jar. Namadheya matram etat anrutam. This is namadheya matram. It is only in name. The pot, etc., is only in name. Anrutam, it is unreal. Mrittika eti eva satyamedi. In that illustration, mrittika or clay alone is real. So says Nyanyane, karanam api vikaravat anta eva shabda matra tu avishyadi asankyaha. But if pot is a word, clay also is a word. So karanapi vikara antameva. Why not clay also is mithya like the pot? Because shabda matra tu avisheshat. Clay also is shabda, pot also is shabda. If shabda is mithya, then clay also is mithya or what? There's no mrittika ityeva satyamiti. Eva shabdena iti shabda sambadhyate. Mrittika iti eva satyam iti. Eva shabdena iti shabda sambadhyate. Iti eva, that's how they have to be connected. That clay alone is real. As clay, it is real. The pot is real. As clay, the pot is real. Or clay alone is real. Look at Ratna Prabha. Karana tudak sattva shunyatvam karyasya sadhyate na aikyamiti. By anandyatvam, we do not mean that they are mutually non-separable. Karana tudak sattva shunyatvam karyasya sadhyate. That karya or effect does not have existence apart from that of the cause. That's what is established here. Nato aikyam. Not that effect and cause are identical. They are non-separate but not identical. So vacharam vag arambhyam nam matram vikarah na karanat pratagasti iti eva karartah mrittika iti eva satyam. But eva karah vag arambhyam nama mrittika iti eva. Mrittika alone is satyam. Not that vikara is satyam at all. Mrittika alone is satyam and not vikara. So vag arabhyam namatram vikara. So what's the reality of pot? Only namatram is only a name. And that name is something that is begun or has its origin in speech. So this so-called pot is no more than the word pot, which word has its origin in speech. Speech. Therefore, the pot has its origin in speech and not in anything else. इति श्रुतिं योजयति एतदुक्तम् इति। तथापि ब्रह्मणि किम् आयातम्। ऑल राइट, सो नाउ यू हैव एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट द पॉट इज अनरियल एंड क्ले इज रियल। पॉट डज नॉट हैव एग्जिस्टेंस अपार्ट फ्रॉम क्ले। द वर्ड पॉट हैज एग्जिस्टेंस ओनली इन नेम। नेम हैज इट्स ओरिजिन इन स्पीच। ऑल राइट, सो नाउ यू अंडरस्टूड द स्टैंड, द इलस्ट्रेशन इज अंडरस्टूड। तथापि ब्रह्मणि किम् आयातम्। What does the illustration have to do with Brahman? So, Vashyaka Esha Iti Esha Brahmanah Drushtantah Amnatah. Understand that this is the illustration with reference to Brahman. So, Drushtantah is given there. Darshtanta is not given in the Upanishad. Understand that Brahma is a Darshtantika, meaning that the Drushtanta is given for explaining the nature of Brahman and Jagat. Says Nyayanena, Drushtantasya Karana Atirikta Karya Abhavashyatvepi Darshtantikasya Nevamiti Asankhya. As far as Drushtanta is concerned, we understand that effect is non-separate from cause. But still, we don't think that that's the case with Jagat and Brahman. So therefore, Phalitamaha Tatra Iti, Bhashyakara says, Tatra Shrutat Vacharambana Shabdat दाष्टान्तिकेपि ब्रह्मव्यतिरेकेण कार्यजातस्य अभावः इति गम्यते। सो तत्र सन्निहितो दृष्टान्तः सप्तम्यर्थः। तत्र मीनिंग इन दैट दृष्टान्त। श्रुताद् Vacharamana Shabdat. In that illustration, the Shruti has used the word Vacharambanam. So that word Vacharambanam, which we hear in that example given by the Shruti, Darshtantikebi. So understand it, Brahma is Darshtantikam. Shruti gives that example for the purpose of asserting the reality of Brahman and the mithyatma of the Jagat. Therefore, darshtantikebi brahma vyatirekena karyajatasya abhava iti gamyate. Therefore, we understand that is that darshtanta is concerned, what illustrated is concerned, the Jagat does not exist apart from Brahma. So this is how that example is explained. Now says Ratnava, Arambana Shabda Arthantaram Aha. The word Arambana also is another meaning of that word is given. Punaschaiti. So Vashyakara says, Punascha Tejo Bandhanam ब्रह्म कार्यताम उक्त्वा तेजो बन्न कार्याणां तेजो बन्न व्यतिरेकेण अभावं ब्रवीते अपागादग्नेरग्नित्वं वाचारम्भणं विकारो नामधेयम् त्रीणि रूपाणित्येव सत्यम् इत्यादिना। So Aramana Shabda appears elsewhere also. Punascha once again. Tejo Bandhanam Brahma Karyatam Aktva. In the Chandogya Upanishad, the Upanishad said how? Tat Aikshada, Tat Teja Asrujada, etc., etc. So then Upanishad explain how Brahman created the element fire and Tat Teja Aikshada, and then that's how Apa Asrujada, it created water, water again, then Aikshanta, then they deliberated and they created this element earth, etc. Having said that, punascha tejo bandhanam brahma karyatam uktva. So Upanishad said that teja, the element fire, is a product of Brahman, and Brahman as fire deliberated and created water, and again Brahman, which was fire, which is now water, deliberated and created earth. Therefore the elements fire, water and earth are the brahma karya, they are the products of Brahman. So brahma karya uktva tejo bandha karyanam tejo bandha vyatirekena abhavam braveete, and further says how the effects of these three elements are not separate from those three elements. So what is punascha? Said Nyayanena, Dushtandavashad, Dhashtandike, Brahma, Atireki, Karya Abhava, Pratipati, Anandaram, Chaityartha. Dushtandavashad, because of Dushtanda of the clay and the parts, Dhashtandike, in Dhashtanda, which is Brahma and Jagat, Brahma Atireki, Karya Abhava, Pratipati. That means that the Jagat, which is the effect of Brahman, does not exist apart from Brahman. Having understood that, then again Upanishad proceeds further. Tadanantaram. So punascha, that's what it means. Brahma karyana mityatvam tat karyana mityadoktyavi darshidam. So brahma karyana mityatvam. In case you have problem with the clay and the pot, and your problem that how does that apply to Brahman, then subsequently Upanishad says how those which are products of Brahman, which is fire, water and earth, how their effects are non-separate from these causes. So brahma karyana mityatvam tat karyana mityato uktyabhi darshitam, that product of fire is not separate from fire, so that is mithya. So product of three elements, fire, water and earth, are not separate from the three elements, so the effects are mithya. So how that, similarly also products of Brahman are not separate from Brahman, therefore Jagat is mithya. So the other way also Upanishad shows that. So said here, punascha tejo bandhanam brahma karyatam uktva. Having said that, the teja, the fire, water and earth are the karya, the effects or products of Brahman. Having said that, tejo bandha karyanam tejo bandha vyatirekena abhavam braveeti. Shruti then clearly says how even effects of the three elements also are not separate from the three elements. Apagat agnehe agnitvam, the fireness of fire is gone. So showing us the fire, Upanishad says apagat agnehe agnitvam, the fireness of fire is gone. Where is it gone? Vacharambram vikara navadev. What is fire? Fire is the vikara, the modification of three elements, fire, water and earth. And therefore ye agnehe rohitam rupam tat tejasah. So the red color that you find in the fire belongs to the element fire. And the white color that you find belongs to element water. And the black color that you find belongs to element earth. So three colors. What is fire? Fire is three colors. Red, white and black. So now when you look at fire closely and then you see that there is only three colors, then there is no more fire. There are only three colors. So apagat agnehe agnitvam. The fireness of fire is gone. Trini rupani ityeva satyam. Only three colors are real. And thus, one by one, so many examples are given to show the mithyatvam. Only three elements are real. And of course, three elements are mithya and Brahman is real. So, trini rupani ityeva satyam. Only three colors are real, ityadina. Says Ratna Prabha, apagat agnitvam, meaning what? Apagatam karanamatratvat. Apagat means avagatam. Agnehe agnitvam apagatam. The fireness of the fire is gone. Karanamatratvat, because the fire is not separate from the karanam, which is the three colors or three elements. Trini rupani, trini tejo bandhanam, rupani, rupatan matmrakani, iti satyam. So trini rupani, itteva satyam. What is trini rupani? What are three colors? Tejo bandhanam, rupani, the colors of the three elements, fire, water and earth. Rupa tanmatrakani, the tanmatras of this rupa. Rupa means the tanmatras of the colors. They alone are the real and the fire is not real. Teshameva sanmatra sattva sanmatratvat sadeva shishyate idabhiprayah. So if you investigate as to what this so-called fire is, you arrive at the conclusion that the so-called fire is nothing but the three colors. That means what are the three elements? And if you investigate what are the three elements, it will be stated subsequently that when you see the earth, it is nothing but water. See the water is nothing but fire. So fire is nothing but except the existence. That's how Teshavi Sanmatratvat, the three elements also are nothing but Sat. Therefore, Sadeva Shishyate Ityabhiprayah, all that remains as reality is existence or Brahman and nothing else. Aramana Shabdadibhyah. Aramana Shabda Adi. What is the Adi? Says Adi Shabdam Vyakhyade. So not only word Arambhana, but other words also are there. The word Arambhana very clearly delineates the mithyatvam, unreality of the jagat. But then there are other words also which also reveal the mithyatvam of the jagat and satyatvam of Brahma. So what is it? Bhashyakara says, Arambhana Shabdadibhyah Ite Adi Shabdad Aitadatma Vidam Sarvam Tat Satyam Sa Atma Tatvamasi Idam Sarvam Yadayam Atma Brahme Vedam Sarvam Atme Vedam Sarvam Neha nanasti kinchana ityamadyapi atmekatva pratipadana param vachana jatam udahartavyam. So not only word arambhana, but other words also indicate what? The ekatvam, the oneness. So it is आत्म एकत्व प्रतिपादन परम आइदर कॉल इट ब्रह्म और आत्मा. सो दिस आरंभण शब्द इन फैक्ट डेलिनेट्स द नॉन ड्युअलिटी ऑफ ब्रह्मन. सिमिलरली देयर आर अदर पैसेजेस इन द उपनिषद्स व्हिच आल्सो रिवील द नॉन ड्युअलिटी ऑफ आत्मा और नॉन ड्युअलिटी ऑफ ब्रह्मन. व्हाट आर दोस पैसेजेस? ऐतत् आत्मम् इदं सर्वम्, इदं सर्वम् ऐतत् आत्मम्. हे सौम्य, हे श्वेतकेतु, दिस यूनिवर्स हैज ओनली सत एज इज आत्मा. तत् सत्यम्, दैट सत् अलोन इज सत्यम्. स आत्मा, दैट इज द आत्मा. सो देयर आत्मा मीन्स एसेंस. ऐतत् आत्मम् सर्वम् मीन्स सत् अलोन इज द एसेंस ऑफ ऑल ऑफ दिस. ऑल ऑफ दिस हैज सत् एज इट्स एसेंस. That as its essence. Tat satyam. And that essence which is sat alone is satyam. That alone is truth or reality. Sa atma. And that is atma. That is a self. Tatmamasi. And that self thou art. It shows the oneness of Brahman and atma. Where aitad atma idam. Aitad has atma. Sat is atma, the essence of the jagat. And that alone is Atma, and that alone is the Satyam, that alone you are. Idam Sarvam, Yadayam Atma, all of this that you see is nothing other than Atma. Brahma Yavidam Sarvam, all of this is indeed Brahman alone. Atma Yavidam Sarvam, all of this is nothing but Atma. Deha Nana Asti Kinchana, here there is no Nana, there is no duality, whatever. इति एवम् आद्यपि आत्मैकत्व प्रतिपादन परम. दिस एंड सिमिलर पैसेजेस एज न्यायेन सेज एवम् आदि इति आदि शब्दात् तदात्मानं स्वयं अकुरुत. प्रॉब्लम मोर पैसेज. तदात्मानं स्वयं अकुरुत, दैट ब्रह्मन क्रिएटेड इटसेल्फ. सो व्हाट इज दिस क्रिएशन? नथिंग बट ब्रह्मन इटसेल्फ. इति वचन जातम उदाहर्तव्यम. सो दिस पैसेज आल्सो आर टू बी प्रेजेंटेड एज उदाहरणम, एज इलस्ट्रेशन. दिस आल्सो कैन बी कोटेड इन सपोर्ट ऑफ द विजन दैट ब्रह्म जगत इज मिथ्या एंड ब्रह्म इज सत्यम. सो दैट इज व्हाट कंसिस्टेंटली द उपनिषद रिवील्स एवरीवेयर. हियर is revealed by the Aramana Shabda. Elsewhere, different words are used. But then, the Jagat Mithyatvam and Brahma Satyatvam is the theme of all the Upanishads. Okay, we'll continue. ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. शङ्करं शङ्कराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः. ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः. ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः. हरिः ॐ श्री